Hi children, good morning everybody. Welcome to 10th standard second language English YouTube classes. My dear children, I hope that you are all utilizing this technology based classes and working hard in your home. Are you? Okay. Children, what is music? Yes, you are right. Music is a passion and it gives peace to the mind and soul. The melody of the music takes us to the another world. Am I right? Definitely, children. It is one of the divine quality on the earth. Whenever that we are disturbed, if we listen the sweet music, our mind will be refreshed and we start to feel calm and cool. That is the richness of music, children. In each and every world, every part of the world, people loves to listen music, children. And at the same way, who have a great love and affection on music, they will perform the music, children. See, we can't play the music. Everybody can't play the music. Only the professionalist, only the trained, only the people who have a great affection and attachment on the particular music field, they can achieve and they can play music. Yes or no? Yes, you are right, children. It is an art. Music is an art, children. And the people who perform music, they loves it and they enjoys. They not only enjoy the music but also makes us to enjoy by feeling the pleasant and sweet music with their performance. In today's class, that we are going to study about one of the poem which is describing the musician, and it tells us the personal and professional life of that musician. You might have guessed that which poem that I am going to deal in today's class. Yes, dear children, you are right that we are going to deal about one of the poem called Jazz Poem 2 by Carl Wendell Hines. Okay, which poem that we are going to deal in today's class, children? Yes, you are right, we are going to deal about the poem Jazz Poem 2 by the Carl Wendell Hines Jr. Then what is jazz? Jazz is a musical instrument. See here, look at this picture. Here there are some musical instruments, children. Are you observing? Are you looking? Yes. See, children, here there is a piano, guitar, sitar, drum, harmonium, isn't it? Jazz, like this, side drum, bass drum, and there are some different musical instruments are seen in this picture, children. Okay, see here, this is the drum, am I right? And whereas this is the guitar, yes or no? And this is called the jazz. Got it, children? Yes, this particular musical instrument is there, na? This is called jaws. Just like saxophone. Saxophone. Have you seen the saxophone, children? Yeah. Yes. Have you heard the music of these musical instruments, children? How do you feel? And what do you feel about the music of these instruments, children? Yes. If we keep on listening these musical instruments, music, children, we will be lost. Yes or no? Yes. But at the same time, if we look at the life of musicians, children, there are some musicians on the world. They have made their name as a great musicians and they are very familiar, children. But the rest of the people, the rest of the musicians, they are not living, they are not leading their life as comfortable as the great musicians or the rich musicians are leading. They also have the sufferings, they also have the feelings, they also have the pain. Compared to their professional life with their personal life, it's very horrifying, children. That changes, that difference has brought out beautifully in this poem by Carl Wendall Ince Jr. in the poem Jaws Poem 2. Okay, who is the poet of this poem, children? Yes. Carl Wendell Ince Jr. And then what is jaws here? Yes, jaws is a musical instrument. Look here, got it? This is the jaws. Okay, just like a saxophone. Have you heard the music of this saxophone, children? Yes, in marriage function and in functions, children, that we could have seen this type of musical instrument and the people who are playing this particular instrument, children. Okay? Yes. Before going to start this poem, children, let us know about the Carl Wendell Ince Jr. Okay. Who is Carl Wendell Ince? Come on, tell me, who is the poet of this poem, children? Yes. Carl Wendell Ince is a poet of this poem. And he was born in 1940 in North California. He graduated from the Tennessee Agriculture and Industrial University in 1964. Okay, his verses have been oyster as some of the best by the contemporary writers. Okay, yes, look at the picture of this Carl Wendell Ince Jr. And this man has written this present poem, the Jaws Poem 2. And this poet is also one of the great musicians. Okay. Before going to start this poem, children, let us know the history. Why does the poet put the title to this poem as a Jaws Poem 2? What are the meaning of the two here? Jaws in the sense, it's a musical instrument, okay. Poem in the sense, okay, it's a name of the poem. What do you mean by the two here? Jaws Poem 2. The title of this poem, children, signifies this is the part 2. Am I right, children? Because the poet Carl Wendell Ince is a great fan of one of the great poet of the English called S.T. Coleridge. S.T. Coleridge has written about the jazz musicians, the Ancient Mariner, like the Ancient Mariner. He has written one of the poem called Ancient Mariner, children. What is Ancient Mariner here? Ancient Mariner is one of the very familiar poem of S.T. Coleridge. Okay, in that poem, The poet S.T. Coleridge has described the one of the singing bird which has shown the route to the people who have lost their way in the sea. Some fishermen were sailing on the sea. They lost their route. To them, that singing bird has shown the route, okay, way to escape or to way to reach their goal or way to reach their destiny. And the same bird, singing bird, was destroyed by the mariner after several years. At that time, they were misled by the god. Okay, this is the gist of that poem which was described by the ancient, which is written by the S.T. Coleridge in Ancient Mariner. Okay, in the same way, in that poem also, the poet described one of the singing bird, beautiful bird, beautiful singing bird, which tells about the music children. And at the same way, in this poem also, the poet is describing one of the musical quality, musical person called the jazz player. That is why he put the title as Jazz Poem 2. Ancient Mariner is a jazz poem 1 and this is 2. But there is no connection with the Ancient Mariner and Jazz Poem 2 children. That was written by S.T. Coleridge and this is written by Carl Wendell Ines. Got it? See here. And in this poem, the poet is giving a message for the message for the people of the world. By using this jazz player, the poet is giving the extraordinary message to the people children. Look at him. He is a pathetic figure, but at the same time, a commanding artist. He has a power in him to make people listen. A gift that may not possess. A gift that not many possess. He is silent in speech but eloquent in music. In a sense, in this poem, the poet is describing the jazz player who looks very simple man, but he is very strong in his music. That's what he is describing in this poem, children. Look at him. He has a power in him to make people listen. It's a quality of music, children. The music, it attracts everybody. Yes or no? Everybody will stand for a while and listen to the sweet music. Yes or no? Yes. In that way, this man was an extraordinary artist. But he is a pathetic figure. He looks very sad. Here, in this poem, the poet has tried to describe about the personal and professional life of the jazz player. Shall we see the poem, children? Okay. Yes. Then all of you open your textbook, page number. Yes, just a minute. Have you opened? Have you opened the textbook, children? Yes. It's okay. Look at the poem, children. This poem, children, that we are also seeing one of the figure. Yes or no? Who is that? Yes, he is a jazz player. Children, do you know what is jazz? Yes, jazz is a musical instrument, just like the saxophone. Yes or no? Yes. First I will recite the poem, children. Okay. After the recitation, I will allow you to read. Then let us see the poem in detail. Okay. Yes, first in today's class, I will deal about the first half of the poem. Okay. Yes. Shall we look at it? If you find any new words, just you underline. While I come to explanation, I will say you the meaning. Okay. There he stands. Look at the figure. Who is he here? Yes. The word he refers to the Josh player whom we are looking at this picture. Okay. There he stands. See. Like a black ancient mariner. His wrinkled old face so full of the worries of the life is turned downward way. Closed eyes, his frayed collar, faded blue old shirt turns dark with sweat and the old necktie undone drops loosely about the worn. Old jacket, just barely holding his sagging stomach in. Yeah, his rundown shoes have paper in them and his rough unshaven face shows pain. In each wrinkle, but he stands in self-brought solitude aid. Still down eyes, still closed ears, perked with trained upon the boss line far across his chest lies an old alto saxophone. Saxophone supported from his neck by a wire coat hanger. Gently he lifts it now to parted lips. See, to tell all the world that he is a black man, that he was sent here to preach the black gospel of Jaws. Now preaching it with it words of screaming notes and quotes, he is no longer a man. No, not even a black man, but yeah, a bird, one that gathers his wing and flies. High, high, higher, until he flies away or come back to find himself a black man again. Look at this picture, children. See, in this poem that we see the two characters of the Jaws player here. In the second half of the poem, that we come to know that how he enjoys as a musician, that is his professional life. But whereas in the first half of the poem, that we come across how pathetic, how sad he is. And we in the first half of this poem, children, that we come across the physical nature, the physical appearance and his personal qualities of this jazz player. Got it? Have you understood, children? Yes. In this poem that we are learning about the personal and professional life of the jazz player. Got it? As we come to know in the beginning, though he looks a very pathetic figure, he is eloquent in music. Got it, children? He is extraordinary musician. That's what that we had seen in the beginning. Let us see the first half of the poem or the personal life or physical appearance of the jazz player in this class. Look at there, children. Okay. Look at there. There he stands. How does he look? How does he look like, children? And whom does the jazz player is compared to in the poem? Yes, he is compared to the like a black ancient mariner. Look at the line here, children. He is compared to the black ancient mariner. So figure of speech of that line, children. Yes, you are right. The figure of speech of that line is a simile. Am I right? See, there he stands. See, like a black ancient mariner. Look at the picture and how the poet has described his physical appearance. How does the poet has described his physical appearance, children? Yes, can anybody tell me? Yes, you are right. He had a wrinkled face. Look at the picture. He had a wrinkled face. Wrinkled in the sense? Yeah. What do the wrinkled face signifies? He is very sad. Unshaven face. Look at there. He has not shaven his face. Okay, unshaved face. The wrinkled face shows the varies of life. Varies of his life. Look at the word varies there, children. What do you mean by varies here? Yes. No longer interest or enthusiastic about anything in life. It means he shows the sadness in his life. Got it? He was very sad. The face itself is telling us the sadness in his life. Got it, children? Okay. Look here. How does the poet describe the mariner here? Sorry, jazz player here? He had a wrinkled face. It is a physical appearance, children. What do the wrinkled face signifies here? The wrinkled face is indicating the sadness in his life. Got it, children? And also, varies of living turn downward with. He is looking down. He is looking at the ground. In a sense, in his life also, he is very sad. He is, tired. And he lost the spirit in life. ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಉತ್ಸಾಹನೇ ಕಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾನೆ ಯಾರು ದಿಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಯರ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ದ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಅಪಿಯರೆನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಈ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಯಾಡ್ ಈ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಯಾಡ್ ಇನ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಈ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಐಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಐಸ್ ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದೇ ದ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಐಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾಥೆಟಿಕ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಯಾಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ And his frayed collar. Look at there. The frayed collar. What do you mean by fray here, children? Look at there. Threads in a piece of clothing starting from apart. Okay, andre. Dara ella horag bandirudu collar inda. Andre, he is wearing a very old and torn dress. What does it indicate? What do the old dress indicate? It indicates the poverty and as well as he was undisciplined. Okay, he was indisciplined, children. Indisciplined, when will be the people become indisciplined, children? When they do not have the interest and when they are not enthusiastic towards the life. ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವಾಗ ಉತ್ಸಾಹ ಕಳ್ಕೊತಾರೆ ಲೈಫಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಆಸೆ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಜೀವನದ ಮೇಲೆ ಉತ್ಸಾಹ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಖುಷಿ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಓಕೆ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಬಡತನ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ವೆನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಪೂರ್ ವೆನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಓಕೆ ವರೀಡ್ ವೆನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಟ್ರಬಲ್ಡ್ ವೆನ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ದೆನ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಲಾಸ್ ದೇ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲೈಫ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಜಾಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಯರ್ ಇಯರ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದೇ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ಇನ್ಡಿಸಿಪ್ಲಿನ್ ಆರ್ ಅನ್ಎಂಥೋಸಿಯಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಲೈಫ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ What things tells us about the unenthusiastic nature of the jazz player here is frayed collar. Got it, children? Frayed in a sense? Okay, torn are the threads which came out from the dress. Faded. Faded means dim. Navudogirudu. Savudogirudu. Got it? faded blue old shirt turns dark with the sweat and the old necktie undone drops loosely about the worn old jacket. Look at this. Look at the dress code, appearance of the Georgia. Okay, they may ask in your examination for 2 marks. How they may ask? Write down about the dress code of the jazz player. Okay, what type of dress he was wearing here? He was wearing a frayed dress which has a frayed collar. And he was wearing a blue shirt that too faded. Faded means dim. Faded andre en makla? Dim anta. Dim andre enu? Navud hogirudu, savud hogirudu. And also, it has become dark with the sweat and sweat. Sweating andre? Bevuru. Bevuru surdu, 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 surdu. Enagide makla? Okay, it has become dark. Kolenu agide. Yavudu? That is shirt. And see, with a sweat and the old necktie, undone drops loosely about the worn old jacket. See, undone drops, necktie. You know, katha kandidare necktie antandre necktie, loose agiro tie. Okay, he was wearing a tie, but it is loose. What does it indicate? Indiscipline and unenthusiastic. Okay, it also shows the sadness. So here, the jazz player has lost the spirit and spirit of life, and okay, he was very sad in his towards his life. The tie, the loose tie. Look here, children. Look here. The dress code of this old jazz player. He was wearing the old dress. Frayed collar, faded blue shirt, and loose necktie. It was undone drops, which was dropping over his stomach. And he wore a old jockey. Apart from that, he was wearing a old dress, blue mantle, blue dress, and loose tie, unshaven face, wrinkled face, and also he was wearing a jacket there. Look at there, children. That old jacket looks just barely holding his sagging stomach in. Look at the word sagging. Antandre netaartidiyala yen netaartirudilli. Look here, what is sagging here? His stomach. Avatte netaartha idu avatte dumanna. Got it? The jacket in which that he is wearing, it looks that it was holding the stomach in. Avan vatta ena eladirkondidiyano anna tara kaanustide. Eno that jacket, what it is, the old jacket is looking that it has holding the sagging stomach in. Sagging in a sense, hanging. What do you mean by sagging here, children? Hanging. Netaadodu. Yav netaadthirodu illi? His stomach. Andre otte dappa ide anta. Alva? What does it indicate? It indicates indiscipline in life. Yava otte dappa agodu? Uta maadi 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 active agilde idre, when we are not active in life, then this type of physical development will occur, children. So that's why here the jacket looks that it is sagging the stomach in. And his run down shoes means the old and torn shoes, kitogirthakanta shoes, have paper in them. And his rough unshaven face shows pain in each wrinkle, but there he stands. Look at that. The shoes that he was wearing, that's also showing his poverty, children. And also, look at this, children. His rundown shoes. What is there in his shoes? Paper in them. And also, rough, unshaven face. He has not shaved, children. His unshaven face also shows the sadness. Got it? ನೋಡಿ ಮನೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರಾದರೂ ದೊಡ್ಡವರು ಶೇವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಂಗೆ ಓಡಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಿರಿಯವರು ಬೈತಾರೆ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಏನಂತ ಹೇಯ್ ಯಾಕೋ ದೇವದಾಸ ಅಂತಾರೆ ಘಟ ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ಯಾ ಅನಲ್ವಾ ಎಸ್ ಬಟ್ ನೌ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಫ್ಯಾಷನ್ ಬಟ್ ಅನ್ಶೇವನ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸಿಂಬಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಡಿಸಿಪ್ಲಿನ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಕಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಯಾಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ಸೋ ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ are explaining the pathetic condition is poverty. These things are expressing the poverty of the jazz player and his indiscipline in life and his unenthusiastic nature in life. Got it? What are the things are explaining his unenthusiastic life, children? His wrinkled face, faded dress, frayed collar, faded shirt, unshaven face, rundown shoes, sagging stomach, these are all shows us the pain of this jazz player and his pathetic condition in his life. Got it, children? It shows the unshaven face shows us the pain in each wrinkle. Okay, every wrinkle in the sense lines on the face. Okay, why is a wrinkle bidutalve? Yes, gere bidutalva? That is, it shows the pain of the jazz player. Seriously, children here, this musician, this jazz player is very poor and he is very sad personally. But there he stands in self-wrought solitude yet. Look at that. But there he stands, the self-wrought solitude yet. Got it? Self-wrought solitude. Solitude in the sense here, the state of being alone. Obre nithidane. Aune? Alone. Loneliness. It tells the loneliness of this person, children. Still down eyes. Still he was looking toward the ground. Still closed ears, perked and trained upon. So slowly he took the one of his tool of his jaws and he trimmed, okay, made it tight. The past line far across his chest lies an old alto saxophone. See, on netartidialadu. What is that? That is the musical instrument called jazz, the saxophone. Okay. Yes. Let us stop here. This is in today's class, children. Let us continue the next class, the remaining part of this lesson, this poem, children. I hope that you have understood the personal life of the jazz player here. Got it, children? In the next class, let's come to the professional. Professionally, he is a musician. He is a jazz player, children. And how he will be? How will be the emotions? How will be his condition? And how will be his attitude when he was playing the music? Okay. Let us study about that in the tomorrow's class. I hope that you have understood his personal life in today's class, children. Have you understood? Okay. Just to do one thing, children, write down the homework. Write about the personal and physical life of the jazz player. I repeat again, children, write about the personal and the physical appearance of the jazz player described in this poem. Okay, Prithiram Makla? Yes. So stop here. Let us see the remaining part in the tomorrow's class. Okay? Yes. Thank you.